I've come along to talk with Deputy Governor Nigel Fisher up at the prison. The story, of course, at the moment, Nigel, is you're again looking for outside interests of people, work that maybe can be done by the prisoners. I mean, this is not new, I know, as such, you've been doing it. But
no, we always struggle to actually get work into the prison. We're always looking for purposeful work for prisoners. So anything we can help in the community, we're up for trying.
I think you've always said in the past that with cutbacks, things get a bit harder anyway, because you probably could have people outside the prison and you've got somebody there to look after them. But are those days over then? You haven't got the staff?
I think we've faced with the same problems that all of government's faced with cuts and headcounts, that we profile our staff to priority jobs, and at the moment out doing work parties isn't a priority, or we haven't got the staff to do it. But it doesn't mean we'll consider jobs. There may be other ways of working around it, other supervision, prisoners risk assessed that are a lower risk. So they may not need that input from prison staff, but we're open to any suggestions. We'll risk assess and come and look at the jobs and see what we can do.
How important is it then from your side to get prisoners engaged with the outside world?
It's critical. I mean, what we're trying to work towards is putting somebody back into society that poses a lot less risk, and basically that we can get them back in employment so that they're earning a wage, they're paying their taxes, they basically get themselves back into society.
So you have to risk assess, I suppose, everybody on this?
Everybody's risk assessed. When we're looking at work, jobs would have to be risk assessed as well, because there may be training involved for certain things, but unfortunately there's always a risk and we've got to manage it best we can.
And do they sign a piece of paper, don't they, to basically say they'll be good people?
We form licences and conditions, terms and conditions, they're quite strict, so if they are going to a certain job and there's somebody supervising, they'd be aware of the license conditions as well, and if they break the conditions, they come back into prison. So
really, I mean, what you've been doing with the media is saying if there's companies out there who have possibly something that might benefit you and them.
Yes, I mean, we do, the way we work at the moment, we do try and look for work with governments, we look for work for charities, and basically we'd be looking at that for free work. If we're looking at private companies, ultimately, if they found somebody suitable for work and they were deemed suitable, they'd have them for a trial period. We would then probably look to have them employed on a minimum wage, so they'd be on a par with anybody else on the outside. If that then worked out, hopefully there's a possibility of a job prospects at the end of it, or in fact just work experience.
So people actually leaving the prison, catching the bus, going to a place of work,
yes,
under very tight conditions?
Yes. We do that at a moment with selected prisoners. Obviously, we can't go into details what they actually do, but we've had a fair amount of successes. We had one individual prisoner that worked locally on a daily basis. It was taken on at the end when they were released, and they're now working full-time. So it's a success story.
So it won't be quite like the UK having the experience with having a call centre running then?
No, I don't think we'd be doing that. That's one step too far, I think. But no, we're open to anything. We'll have a look at it and risk assess it. I mean, the economy's a scale. We only have a small prisoner population. We've got varying different offences and different prisoners. So the thought of 90-odd prisoners are all suitable for outside work, the reality isn't there. We've got to do them, assess them. Some will always be working in the prison. Some will never work out of the prison. But there are a lot of people that can work in the community.
And a good success rate, you say, on this?
Yeah, small numbers, but we've got various different people doing different jobs. I said I can't go into too much detail, but to date everything's worked fine. It takes a lot of planning, a lot of organisation, lots of months before we can get up and running, which sometimes the prisoners don't understand, but they've obviously got to be patient until we can set these risk assessments up, talk through, make sure everybody's comfortable, the employer and the individual and the prisoners and their colleagues. But they're working well so far. We'll be right back.